action lawsuit was filed this week against SeaWorld. It claims that the company defrauds customers at its San Diego water park when it says that the killer whales in captivity are happy or healthy. The lawsuit insists the animals live in stressful, unhealthy conditions. Now, SeaWorld fired right back in a statement, saying, quote, "The suit is baseless, filled with inaccuracies, and SeaWorld intends to defend itself against these inaccurate claims." Now, SeaWorld has been under fire ever since the documentary Blackfish aired right here on CNN. It was harshly critical of how killer whales in its custody are treated. The fallout was devastating. And as CNN's Martin Savage reports, SeaWorld is now fighting to survive.
They're just in this dark metal 20-foot by 30-foot pool for two-thirds of their life.
Ever since CNN aired the controversial documentary Blackfish about the mistreatment of killer whales in captivity, SeaWorld has been sinking. Attendance is down by a million, and its stock price has dropped 40% in the last year. Now the company's fighting back.
There's been a lot of unfair criticism about SeaWorld these days.
With a new ad campaign.
So don't believe what PETA and Blackfish are saying.
SeaWorld has also announced plans to significantly increase the size of its facilities for killer whales in its marine parks across the country, including this one located here in San Antonio, Texas. It would essentially double the water volume of their habitats. But SeaWorld's critics also have new ammunition. A book by a former SeaWorld trainer blasts the marine park for, among other things, keeping killer whales captive purely for entertainment.
I just don't think killer whales should be dancing around to Jennifer Lopez songs, and trainers should be doing dance steps with glow sticks, and it's just a circus. It's just a glorified circus.
Ironically, the circus delivered its own blow to SeaWorld. Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus says by 2018, it'll no longer have elephants under the big top due to changing public attitudes. SeaWorld turned down our request for an interview, but in the past has defended its programs, saying its killer whales receive world-class care. Animal activists would like to see SeaWorld retire its killer whales from showbiz too and put them into water sanctuaries. I brought you here because I wanted to give you an example, and this is it. A bay with a net that would be strung across the entrance so that the killer whales could be on one side protected and cared for. And then all around them, they'd be in a living ocean. But some experts say SeaWorld's biggest problem isn't Blackfish, but SeaWorld.
The CEO, along with his management team, didn't manage that process of fighting back against Blackfish very well.
Which explains why SeaWorld has a new CEO. Joel Manby has experience overseeing places like Dollywood and acts such as the Harlem Globetrotters. But it may not be just a PR problem. Competitors like Universal Studios have added high-tech attractions, like the Wizarding World of Harry Potter, and as a result, they're seeing record attendance. Critics say that should be a lesson for SeaWorld, to become a theme park focused on the sea and sea life that captivates the imagination rather than killer whales. Martin Savage, CNN.
We contacted SeaWorld multiple times, both by email and by phone, to request an interview. They declined. Up next, two former SeaWorld trainers.